Simon & Schuster Audio presents Run the Storm. A savage hurricane, a brave crew, and the wreck of the SS El Faro. By George Michelsen Foy. Read by L.J. Ganser.
This book is dedicated to the courageous, steadfast, and skilled men and women of El Faro, and to the families and friends of El Faro's crew, who have honored their memory with grace and fortitude, and to the unsung heroes of the American Merchant Marine, who work hard, lonely hours, day in, day out, in conditions that are usually unrecognized, often uncomfortable, and sometimes perilous, to supply their country with 90% of everything. I came to explore the wreck. The words are purposes. The words are maps. I came to see the damage that was done and the treasures that prevail. Adrian Rich, diving into the wreck. He said to run it. Hold on to your ass, Larry. Daniel Randolph, second mate of the SS El Faro. Crew of the SS El Faro. Deck Department. Michael C. Davidson, 53, Captain, Windham, Maine. Stephen W. Schultz, 54, Chief Mate, Roan Mountain, Tennessee. Danielle L. Randolph, 34, Second Mate, Rockland, Maine. Jeremy H. Ream, 46, Third Mate, Camden, Delaware. Roan R. Lightfoot, 54, Bosun, Jacksonville Beach, Florida. Roosevelt L. Bootsy Clark, 38, deckhand, Jacksonville, Florida. Larry Brookie Davis, 63, able seaman, Jacksonville, Florida. Frank J. Ham III, 49, able seaman, Jacksonville, Florida. Carrie J. Hatch, 49, able seaman, Jacksonville, Florida. Jack E. Jackson, 60, able seaman, Jacksonville, Florida. Jackie R. Jones, Jr., 38, able seaman, Jacksonville, Florida. James P. Porter, 40, deckhand, Jacksonville, Florida. Mariette Wright, 51, deckhand, St. Augustine, Florida. Engine Department. Richard J. Pusatere, 34, chief engineer, Virginia Beach, Virginia. Jeffrey A. Mathias, 42, Riding Crew Supervisor, Kingston, Massachusetts. Keith W. Griffin, 33, First Engineer, Fort Myers, Florida. Howard J. Shonley, 51, Second Engineer, Cape Coral, Florida. Michael L. Holland, 25, Third Engineer, North Wilton, Maine. Mitchell T. Cufflick, 26, Third Engineer, Brooklyn, New York. Dylan O. Mecklen, 23, Third Assistant Engineer, Rockland, Maine. Louis M. Champa, 51, Electrician, Daytona Beach, Florida. Joe E. Hargrove, 65, Oiler, Orange Park, Florida. Herman A. Solar Cortez, 51, Oiler, Orlando, Florida. Anthony Sean Thomas, 47, Oiler, Jacksonville, Florida. Sylvester C. Crawford, Jr., 40, Wiper, Lawrenceville, Georgia. Stewards Department. LaShawn L. Rivera, 32, Chief Cook, Jacksonville, Florida. Theodore E. Kwame, 67, Chief Steward, Jacksonville, Florida. Lonnie S. Jordan, 35, Assistant Steward, Jacksonville, Florida. Riding Gang. Piotr M. Krau, 27, Gdynia, Poland. Marcin P. Nita, 34, Poland. Jan P. Piodorski, 43, Poland. Andrzej P. Truszkowski, 51, Poland. Rafał A. Zbrodnik, 42, Poland. Author's note. Run the Storm is a work of nonfiction. The author has drawn on thousands of pages of documentation from three separate hearings and separate working groups conducted by the U.S. Coast Guard and the Federal National Transportation Safety Board to solve the mystery of what happened to El Faro. The hearings, conducted by maritime experts, called scores of witnesses and were followed by months of painstaking analysis. The author has supplemented the record with dozens of interviews with family members, former officers and crew, search and rescue personnel, government officials and spokespersons, independent mariners, meteorologists, and others. This book also draws heavily on the 26 consecutive hours of bridge conversation and other data recovered from the vessel's black box or voyage data recorder. The drama of hearing the actual voices affords a unique, if emotionally difficult, opportunity to understand firsthand what El Faro's crew were thinking and doing as they sailed into the wrath of Hurricane Joaquin. The conversations used are all direct quotes. They have been edited only for coherence and to avoid repetition, and occasionally to restore some government-redacted salty language used by the crew. In all cases, the guiding principle was to remain faithful to meaning and context. Most important, this fact remains, there are no witnesses to recount exactly what happened to El Faro as she went into the storm. The VDR gives us a tremendously useful and accurate tool to track decisions and anxiety levels on the bridge. So when an action is clearly implied by both the conversation and the overall likelihood of its taking place, such as when a navigating officer points out course details, implying that he or she is looking at a chart, that action is described accordingly. Except in instances when both sides of a phone or radio dialogue could be heard, conversations in the rest of the ship went unrecorded, and so description of what happened in, say, the galley or engine room must be based on guesswork. But any ship relies on solid, recurrent routines to function, and a ship on liner service, as El Faro was, making exactly the same passage week in, week out, year in, year out, enjoys more fixed routines than most. The mariners standing an 8 a.m. to noon watch, for example, always woke well before 8 to eat breakfast. They always reported to the bridge, or the engine room control flat, 15 minutes before their watch started, as is the custom on shipboard. The watch rosters and schedules on El Faro were well known and apparently adhered to rigidly on all her voyages. The VDR transcript in almost every instance indicates that crew members and officers stuck by those routines exactly. And while the author is careful to indicate that unrecorded events are presumed rather than certain, he has faithfully described unrecorded actions of the crew based on what they would normally have done aboard El Faro on the southbound leg of her journey. Part 1. The Silence. A ship is safe in harbor, but that is not what ships are built for. John Augustus Shedd. 1. Toward the end of the 4 a.m. to 8 a.m. watch on the morning of October 1st, 2015, the image of his friend Larry came to Kurt Brewer's mind. Brewer is a 5'11", 40-year-old of solid build, firm jaw, and an expression when he's not wearing sunglasses that reads both confident and wary. That morning, as an able seaman, or AB in the parlance, an experienced deckhand in the American Merchant Marine, he was standing watch on the bow of the Texas Enterprise, making sure no traffic got too near his cargo ship, full of bulk-loaded grain, anchored in the flat early morning light field of the Mississippi River. Brewer's friend, Brookie Davis, known as Larry, was much older. That morning he was AB on a different vessel, the SS El Faro, a giant cargo ship working a bi-weekly shuttle run between North Florida and Puerto Rico. Despite the difference in age, Brewer and Davis were as close as mariners got. Brewer had worked for a year on El Faro, and on that ship he ate with Davis at mealtimes. Sometimes they hung out in the crew's lounge or talked shop when working overtime together. In Jacksonville, where both lived, the two would occasionally meet for a beer or for a few hands of poker at Best Bet, one of the clubs south of the Dames Point Bridge over the St. John's River, close to where El Faro docked. They had not seen as much of each other recently. Brewer had left El Faro the previous year.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.